Alright guys, welcome back. Alright, so we're down to what should be one of the final videos for Final Fantasy V Advance. Alright, so what we're going to be tackling this time is the Cloister of the Dead. Almost called it the Cloister of Trials. Alright, so Bartz has Jump in Blue. Lena can keep Dual Cast White Time. Focus Spellblade. You can have Focus Spellblade. Let's check everyone's equipment. Don't need any of those anymore. You can have your Sage's Staff. Give her the Genji Shield. That should be good. Let's save with that before we get started. Okay, so once we get started on the Cloister of the Dead, we're pretty much stuck in it until the end, if we want to get all the way to the end, that is. If we give up partway through it, we have to start all the way from the beginning. Hordes of strong enemies traverse the Cloister of the Dead. Those who are negligent will quickly perish. I'll certainly give it a shot. Okay, so boss rush time. This guy from the very beginning of the game? Now, they have been beefed up a bit. Not by much, but a little. Alright, Garula. He's gonna counterattacks. Shouldn't counter magic, though. Oh, he's gone. Round three. Siren. Hey, goodbye, Siren. Four. Forza and Nagisa. Force is gone, and so is Magisa. Right, final battle of this stage, and it's the Gill Turtle. So you guys are going to use Spellblade Blazaga. Barts are gonna cast Mighty Guard. Lena. Dispel and Holy. Dispel's gonna get rid of its innate Protect and Shell. And then it's weak to Ice. Since we're floating, Earthquake didn't hit us. Goodbye to the Guild Turtle. Okay, so stage one completed. Oh, something else to note about these battles. You always fight them in the exact same order. Let's see, for stage two. Time magic's probably not gonna do us much good here. So let's go for summons. Okay, so in between every five battles, you get a little bit of a rest period. Use that time to restore your MP, change your jobs or abilities, what have you. Alright, on to the next stage. Okay, let's rock. Didn't really need Golem, but I figured I'd give him something to do. Now, Spellblade Bazaga instantly kills Liquid Flame. It's kind of sad. Okay, the Soul Cannon. This time we'll go for Spellblade Thundaga. You cast level 5 death. Okay, that gets rid of the launchers. And goodbye, Soul Cannon. Hmm. go with Spellblade Flare. Alright, now I don't know if this is gonna work, but I'm gonna try. Let's try summoning Odin. Oh, it is gonna work. Nice! Got the Zantetsuken on the Pearl Bolos. Oh, but they... Okay, so in that case... try to silence all of them first. Alright, now we'll summon Odin again. And they should be able to cast Arise this time. No effect! Okay, now for Minotaur. Just like in Fork Tower, all of our magic is going to be disabled. So unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to do a whole lot here to help. At least magic-wise. Oh, never mind. Minotaur's dead. Last boss is these guys. Goodbye. Zantetsuken still works on those three little pigs there. Let's see. Lena, I can probably switch you back over to time magic for now. Okay, on to stage 3. Let's rock. Okay, so Biblos. Should die instantly to Spellblade Faraga. Yep, goodbye, Deadlos. Okay, same goes for the Tyrannosaur. probably try throwing a phoenix down at it, too. Oh! Okay, that works, too. Deathclaw on the Dragon Pod. It should work. Let's just wait a moment. There we go. First one missed, but all I had to do was mimic it. To the dragon flowers. Alright, so Archaeodaemon. Gonna have to be careful with him. Let's throw Mighty Guard up. So, just like last time, we're going to have to cast Reflect on him. Otherwise, every time he's attacked, he's just going to keep casting Death on himself to fully restore himself with full HP. The only thing we can really do against him is Meteor, at least with magic. Let's go for the double meteor. Oh, that's gonna hurt. God, that did nothing. Okay, we got him. Goodbye to the Archaeodaemon again. Last one. Oh, it's you again. Looks like that protect didn't help you very much there, dude. I'm surprised the panda was the last boss of this stage, and not the Archaeo Demon. Let's go ahead and put Summon back on Lena now. Okay, stage 4, here we come. Again, first up is the Manticore. Now Odin should work. Yep. Zantetsuken. Goodbye, Manticore. Adamantoise. It should still be weak to Spellblade Bazaga. So dispel to get rid of its innate Captain Shell. Dies instantly to Spellblade Bazaga. My bad. Jackanapes. Shouldn't even really need to try for this thing, really. Oh, it can use Moon Flute. Well, it's dead, though. Now that's that thing that you could actually run into in the castle wall's basement. I never did get past it though. I forget what kind of treasure you can find in the basement. Oh well. Aw, don't make Lena old. There goes Cloister, or however you say her name. Last boss, Twintania. Alright, so he's weak to Holy. We're gonna throw up Mighty Guard because he tends to like to counterattacks with Tidal Wave, which does hurt after a while. Or he could just use Mega Flare. Paper by Twentania. We'll give you black magic for this next one, why not? Okay, stage 5. We're actually getting close to the end now. Alright, let's go for Silence. Because you might remember with Omniscient, if he's hit with a physical attack, then he's gonna just cast Return to... return us to the start of the battle. Okay, good, we silenced him. By Omniscient. Alright, time for the guessing game again. Ooh, nice, I actually found... Oh, wait. Okay, now he's gonna rotate positions. Oh no, my mind! Nice, found the right one there. Hmm. I'm on down, Bartz. Hey, look, it's a sandworm. Oh, wait, it doesn't like to have magic cast on it. Hope this kills it. Yay. I forgot, it doesn't like to have magic cast on it. Okay, now, as for you... I think that... we can try to use spell blade sleep. Okay, he's asleep. Let's keep it that way. Tamos. Now this dude. Alakanarsis, that's how you say his name. You're out of there. Okay, stage 5 complete. Alright, now we're gonna put summons back on Lena. Okay, now the next stage, stage 6, should be the last. Okay, final stage, here we go. Alright, now for this fight, all we should have to do is summon Odin again. Yep, Zantats again. Goodbye to the crystals. If we hit her with Faraga before she can change her polarity or change her weakness, then we should be able to defeat her pretty quickly. Now, because we're floating, all he can do is cast 100 Gs, but because we have float on, he's going to spend the rest of the battle trying to put us back on the ground and not be able to. Poor guy's not going to be able to do anything to us. What a catastrophe. Azulmagia. Now, I think he's weak to bio, so I'm gonna give Spellblade Bio a shot. Oh no, my level! This should be the final boss of the Cloister of the Dead. Necrophobe. Thank you. need to destroy those barriers before we can hurt Necrophobe himself. One. Two. Let's go for a white wind. Okay, barriers are gone. Let's cast Carbuncle. This is why I casted Carbuncle, or summoned Carbuncle, because he counters with Flare. And I remember this is actually what wiped me out last time. His counter flares wiped my team out right at the end, which really sucked. But not this time. Goodbye, Necrophobe. We survived the Cloister of the Dead. I see you've returned safely. I assume that means you have defeated the monster hordes, correct? Then I bestow upon you this token extolling your triumph. Medal of Smiting. Cool. Honoring triumph over the legions of darkness and awarding the title of Smiter of Evil. That's pretty cool. Yeah, I'm quite proud of myself. I actually managed to beat it this time. I remember being disappointed because I died at the very end when I recorded this all those years ago. Alright guys, I'm probably just going to do one more quick video, and that'll be for like the bestiary and the music player and stuff. So, I'll see you guys in the bonus video.